and welcome to Tomorrowland Around the World. I very much hope that you're still enjoying your day here at the Digital Festival, and we are ready. We are so ready for another Tomorrowland Inspiration Session. It's going to be a special one this time because we invited a very special guest, Gaggan Anand. Very good afternoon.
Hi, good afternoon. How are you doing?
Doing magnificently well. Very much looking forward to this inspiration session, mainly because you are one of the most decorated chefs in Asia. For those who don't know you, you have an amazing restaurant in Bangkok. You have a way of experimenting with food in many different ways that still allure a lot of people. But most of all, you are a rebel. Can I put it like that?
Yeah, I think so. I'm a proper rebel. I'm a real rebel.
Okay. Now, it's always easy to say, I'm a rebel, I'm this, but we have actual proof that you are a little bit of a rebel. So I propose that we watch a small clip of you just as a way of introducing you. And I know that I may have made a few mistakes, but I know that I learned a lot along. How does a chef come up with the idea of making a music video like that?
I try my best to put things into perspective of life. And food, music are very human things. And if you merge it well together, you see, we are in last 6 months, the only two things we know well is entertainment, sitting home, and cooking in home.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, these are the two most important human things that have been mostly risen up in this last 6 months of depressive human behavior. And I think that is why I've combined two things, which are two genres, to be put into one stream, where music, which is my first love, and my cooking is my second love, and how I change my first love into second love and second love into first love.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's very well put. Gaggan, I'm going to ask you a question that I think you've been asked 1,000 times, but it's still very interesting, I think, to this conversation. Where does your passion for food, for being a chef, come from?
I think it comes from the inspirations that I carry, and I think life itself is an inspiration. Mm-hmm. Cooking is not a destination. It's not about a recipe. It's about a journey. You evolve. Yeah. You evolve, and it's a journey of a butterfly. You start with a cocoon. Okay, you start with a warm cocoon and a butterfly, and then you die. It's like eat, repeat, eat, you know, and sleep. And that's how it is. So cooking is a kind of a revolution of evolution of a chef. And that is very important because we all have our arts and we all have our skill. We all can be incredible in a computer sitting on a job, but the skill of seducing a community, a crowd, with your magic in your hands, which is what DJs do, what musicians do, what guitarists do, what singers do, we do with food. And the chef has that magic in the hand, which is the seduction of people. When you eat a coffee, like you eat a cake, can you think of a chocolate cake and think that you're eating a strawberry cake? You cannot. Your mind is seductive. You're in that. And that is why it's very important to never give up your rights. No. Never give up the fight. Because if we give up our fight, we will even lose before losing.
That's a very positive mindset you have. Is that something that you learned to be, or were you born that way? Where from a very young age, did you have that mindset?
I think I got my life's lows quite early in life. And I think I always lived this 29 years of my first life as a cursed life. And because of the 29 years of cursed life, I could relate myself with the empathy of a commoner.
Yeah.
You know, we live in a social status. We live in a class system. We live in so many parallel worlds. Some are born to be rich. Some are born to be poor. We don't try to change lives around us. And I think that is the biggest problem with us. Mm-hmm. And today we live in a very selfish way. But mm-hmm. I always thought that I have responsibility and I have that power to change people around me.
Yeah.
And that's what I do. And that's why I don't give up. Because if I give up, I always look at how many people around me will suffer because I gave up. And I can't give up.
That's a crushing responsibility.
It's everybody has a responsibility. You're not a leader for a reason that you're a leader. Leadership comes with responsibility and respect. And you can't buy that. You cannot buy leadership.
No. And on that subject, Gaggan, you recently did a very rebellious thing by quitting your restaurant Gaggan and restarting or reopening a new one with Gaggan Anand. How did that come about? I mean, that's about as rebellious as it can get, the maximum freedom, I think.
Moving a transition of our comfort zone to coming to something uncomfortable is not easy. Mm. But I hate comfort. I hate to be in that comfort zone. We can't just make one album and one hit wonder in music. No. Food, you can't just make two recipes and that's your life. No. You have to constantly evolve and keep innovating. Today's world is about innovation. It's about innovation, adaptability, and how we convert all the problems you have in life into positivity. Because what we need now is, if I would say I am Gaggan, and who cares? Who the fuck cares who I am? The only people who care is the one who puts my food in his mouth or her mouth and then go to the space I created for them.
Yeah.
Food is the hero. I'm not the hero. So I always want my food to reflect, and names can change, but I am Gaggan and nobody can change me. Your name has no value until you are there. And that is the most important part.
What I wanted to talk about as well is you always talk about innovating, experimenting with food. Are there any projects, very wild projects that are in your head, but you would like to do at some point in your life when it suits the time, when it fits?
I started doing a coffee project, which is coming soon.
Okay.
Okay, it's a coffee project with a fashion, street fashion brand and my other restaurants. We're making a coffee brand.
Okay.
Second we're doing is I'm opening a culinary school. It's a super project. And it's a culinary school that focuses on Asian cuisine only. The problem is, if you want to become a chef, now you say in COVID, and this is the most common question I get, I am a pilot, but since I can't fly and I don't like flying anymore, I want to be a chef. Oh my God, you wasted your 10 years of flying a plane and you never wanted to fly. And now you want to realize you are a chef, but you have a chance. Why is it that only a person at 20 can be a chef, and why not at 30 or 40 or 50?
Yeah, it's true.
Yeah, so the profession-wise, I want to create opportunity with Asian cuisine.
Okay.
I want to give more importance to rice than a bread. Because we were born in Asia, and we ignore our own existence.
What do you mean by that, Gaggan?
It's like, I'll tell you. I last saw my grandmom when I was 9 years old, 8, 9 years old. I don't have a memory of her recipes, but I have her memory in my mouth.
Yeah.
And I tried to cook those things. And when I reach my recipe to the mouth that I remember, I get my eureka moment. I did something which my grandmother did not leave me behind as a legacy of a cookbook.
No.
And we are in that threat. We are in this threat. How many musicians even listen to Mozart?
Yeah.
How many people even consider music to go back to 100 years back? Or Beethoven or things like that. So it's the same thing with food. We are losing. But COVID did one thing. We all went back to cooking. The restaurants were closed. Everybody started making bread and omelette. So I am so happy that when somebody cooks a dish, he says, shit, being a chef is not easy, right? So it's a kind of thing. So I think cooking has made us human. Mm-hmm. You and I and everybody is watching this video are born to be animals. But the only difference between you and me and the animals is that we, when we eat something cooked, we relax. But a monkey to a giraffe to a snake to a lion will eat in aggression. We eat to relax. And that's why we are humans.
Okay. Cooking sets us apart from the animals.
Yes, cooking. Cooking and music, of course, and other creative forms. But cooking, you can live without music. You can live without art. You can live without clothes. You cannot live without food.
Okay.
And the moment cooking goes away from human industry, our human psychology, we will become animals. We won't know how to relax.
Gaggan, that was I'm completely in your trip. It's very inspiring. This is what an inspiration session has to look like. And it sounds to me like this COVID situation has you've shifted it in something very positive. You only see the positive side to it. If you look at where you come from, your background, it's not always easy to keep a positive mindset, I think. How do you do it?
I think you have to be fearless, one, and you have no insecurity to lose what you have. What are you ready to lose to win the battle you want to win? And that's the question you ask. And that's the only thing. I was ready to lose, and I'm still ready to lose. Let's hope the COVID goes away. But if it doesn't go away, what am I putting in line? I will put, and this is what I spoke to my employees, my team, my family. I told them, I will go down to my last penny and pay you the salary. But if I don't have money to live, we all will look for a job. Mm-hmm. 70 of us. 70 of them and one of me. So this is exactly the attitude I carry. I luckily came from a family where we didn't have money. And that made me naive. And that made me fearless. And they are the coins with two sides. Because naive helps you to fight your inner battles here. Our strength is here, not here. This is bullshit. This is bullshit. Your strength is here. It's here, right here. And your inner strength will carry you forward in times like this. And the only thing you have to think about is positive.
One more question. You wanted to call this be a rebel. Being able to cope with losing everything, putting everything online is important. I think that is also part of being a rebel. And is that why you wanted to name this session Be a Rebel?
Yeah, because I'll tell you one thing. Being a rebel doesn't mean picking a knife. That's wrong. That's absolutely wrong.
No, that's being a criminal.
Yeah, no, I'll tell you. I'm telling you because people might interpret us as wrongly rebel, right? Mm-hmm. Being a rebel, I come from a country which is famous for Gandhi.
Yeah.
And he was a rebel. And he did not say, he would not even pick up a weapon or a fight. All they would say is, you can slap on my face, but I'm thick skinned. And you can keep slapping me and keep slapping me and your hands will be tired, but my thick skin will not be tired. And that's a real rebel. The real rebel is the one who fights for it and fights with peace and love. You can't fight with anger and animosity. The anger is your aggression that will take you forward. But remember one thing, never give up. Because if you give up, you've lost it before even you won it. Even if you have a chance to win it. Who cared? Who cared about Asian cuisine? Who cared about Indian food to be where it is? Who cared? And this is what it is. We have to take sure and make sure that what we believe in, you fight for it. You fight till you die. And you died fighting. That's what it is.
Gaggan Anand, thank you very much for this session.
Thank you, Esther. Thank you. Love you all.
Love you.